This is Ben from Compete Themes, and in this beginner WordPress tutorial, you'll learn how to create a photo gallery in WordPress for free without installing any new plugins. Let's get started by logging into the WordPress dashboard now. Once you're inside the admin dashboard, navigate to either a post or page you'd like to add a gallery to. For my example, I'll click on the Pages menu, and then once it loads, I'll select my sample page. Keep in mind that the following steps work the same way for posts too. Inside the editor, I'll click at the end of this paragraph and then press the Enter key to create a new block. Now to insert the gallery, start by clicking on the plus button on the left to open up the block menu. You might see the gallery block listed inside the most used section, but if not, close this section and then open up the common block section and you'll see it listed here. Click on gallery and you'll see the new block added right away. The gallery block will ask you to either upload images or select them from your media library. I'll click on the media library button and you should recognize this window that pops up. To add images into your gallery, just click on them here to select them for inclusion. If you add an image by accident, you can hover over the check mark and click the minus button to deselect it. Once you've chosen the images you want in your gallery, press the Create New Gallery button at the bottom right of the screen. On the next page, you can customize your gallery in a few ways. First, you can drag and drop the gallery items to reorder them. Next, you can enter captions using the box beneath each image. And lastly, you can remove images by clicking the X button or add more images by clicking the Add to Gallery link over here. When you're happy with your settings, click the Insert Gallery button at the bottom of the screen. As you can see, the gallery has now been added into the page, and the way you see it displayed here is how it will show up on the front end of your site for visitors too. Now you know how to create and add galleries to your posts and pages, but before we wrap things up here, let's just take a quick look at the remaining customization options. By default, WordPress galleries will use up to 3 columns and set a larger display for images that don't fit perfectly into these columns. While the gallery block is selected, you can use the column setting in the right sidebar to increase or decrease the number of columns in the gallery. Next, you'll probably want to leave this crop option on since it will keep the grid nice and even. Turning off cropping can lead to some irregular lines, which can make the gallery display look kind of ugly. Lastly, this setting here lets you link all of the images to their attachment pages, the media files, or no link at all. If you click on an image in the gallery, you'll see the X button at the top right allows you to remove it, and the arrow buttons can be used to easily rearrange the images. Below the images are the original buttons for adding new images to the gallery via upload or your media library. And one last option you might like is the gallery caption, which lets you add a caption for the entire gallery rather than for just one image. If you want a simple way to add an attractive photo gallery to WordPress, then the gallery block is an excellent option. It's easy to use, free, and completely responsive, which means it looks just as good on mobile devices as on your laptop. That's everything you need to know to create an image gallery with WordPress. And if you like this tutorial, then make sure to subscribe so you can catch my next tutorial too. Don't forget to hit the like button before you go, and if you have any questions, just post in the comments section below. Thanks so much for watching.